how to create YouTube end screens in Adobe Spark. Stick around. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today we're talking about how to create end screens for your YouTube channel using Adobe Spark. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at spark.adobe.com. I'm going to start by clicking on the blue plus sign and go to custom size graphic. Now, since we're creating end screens for YouTube, we're going to go with 1920 by 1080. Now, if you upload 4K footage, you could always double up the size or create a new one with 4K dimensions. But we'll go ahead and use 1920 by 1080 here and click on next. And we're going to have a blank screen, a canvas to use here. Now you can be creative and add some really cool backdrops or backgrounds or your own picture. So we'll go ahead and do several here. We'll go with backgrounds over here on the left. And there's some really neat looking ones. We've got some geometric ones. We've got some organic ones. So I'm going to go with, let's say, a stationary style, maybe like with a paper kind of format here. This is cool. Cool toned paper. So we'll go with that one there. And let's say, let's go with this one right here. And we'll go ahead and, yep, that looks pretty good. We'll use that one and we'll go ahead and rotate that. So make it fit into this size. Let's move that over here to the left and just increase the size here. It's okay if it goes over. There we go. So let's go ahead and go with the circle. Let's go with icons here and we'll click on the circle here and let's go ahead and we'll move this one in the middle here. We'll set that one up in the middle. One of the things that I like doing with my end screens is I'll make the circle a little bit smaller because you could always increase the size of the subscribe circle. I'll go ahead and change the color to white here. It'll work just fine. And now what we'll do is let's go to icons again and we'll use rectangle and we will bring in a rectangle to use for those watch more options. So let's go ahead and go with this rectangle here. And we'll move this one to the side here and let's size that up. And I think that'll work right there. We'll change the color to white and then we'll do this. We will duplicate this and we'll move that one over here, even it out. There we go. And one of the things I'll do here is I'll shift click. I've got all those three selected. Make sure they're centered. We'll align it. I'll go ahead and group them and perfect. So now what I'm going to do is create one of those titles here, watch more, and then also subscribe. So we'll go to text and click on add your text. And let's type in subscribe. And this is where you can get really creative with the type of font you'd like to use. We'll go with white here. You can, again, choose any color. I'm just gonna go with the white. We'll move the subscribe because this is where we usually subscribe. It's this circle button right here. So we'll move the subscribe there. And well, let's go ahead and change the font so we can pick whichever one we want. I'm gonna go ahead and go with the Proxima Nova. Let's go with bold. That looks pretty neat. And move it down just a tad bit right there. I'm going to go ahead and duplicate that. I'm going to move that up here to the top and double click that and we'll say watch more. We want people to watch more of our videos. You can put it right here in the middle or you can say watch more here. And you can say, let's duplicate that and move that one over here. You can say something like watch this, watch more, watch this. Again, this is whatever you want it to be, depending on how you will add this to your videos when you are editing. I'm gonna go ahead and just drop that out. And we'll move this one back up here. Maybe make this a little bit bigger. You want people to kind of notice that, watch more. And now what we'll use is icons and we're going to add an arrow. Because we want to point people in the direction of where to watch. So let's see. Let's wonder if there's a curved arrow. Let's see, let's keep scrolling down till we find one, I think. One of these might work here. Maybe a curved arrow. So let me type in, let me turn off my caps there. Curved arrow. So let's see what comes up when we type in curved arrow. Okay, I think that works. So we got this one, this one. Let's go ahead and go with that one right there. Let's see where it's at. There it is. We do watch more. So we got this. Let's rotate this around. Line that up. Make it a bit smaller. Yeah. Oh, I moved the wrong one there. There we go. We're going to slide that right there. And change the color to white. And let's go ahead and duplicate that. Move it over here. And then we will flip. Center that there. And now what I'll do is let's make this bigger. Watch more. There we go. Boom. There we have our end screen. So now when I add this to my editing tool, I can just drop this towards the end of my video. And then when I import it to YouTube, I can just drag those videos, watch more videos right here, and then the little subscribe buttons. And let's go ahead and call this YT for YouTube end screen. We'll do 01. So now I've got this one ready, and I'll go ahead and download that. Solid. Cool. So we've got that downloaded. Now, if I want to, I can go ahead and let's change this up. We'll go to ungroup, and we're going to delete one of these circles here, or I should say rectangle. Let's group this together here. We're going to move this down here, and we'll delete the arrows. We'll do the watch more, make it a little bit smaller, and then we'll put this here. So it has the different type of end screen. Let's go ahead and select all these here. We're going to line these up. Perfect. We'll move this up a little bit. Cool. And now get a little creative here, make this end screen. I'm going to add a photo here. So let's go to my Lightroom folder. You click on upload. You could upload from your desktop or wherever you have your photo saved. I've got my social media promo images here. I'm going to bring in one of my photos. It's going to be used for my end screen. And let's kind of keep scrolling until I find it. Should be coming up right about there. This is going to be my end screen here. I'm going to add this, and here I'm going to crop this and scroll down to circle, and I went ahead and cropped my picture there. Let's adjust that crop, bring that down. And now what I can do is let's go ahead and change this background here, replace. So I click on the background, replace. Let's use something a little bit different. Let's go with, that one right there and see how it looks. Cool, that works, kind of like a somewhat of a chalk looking thing. Okay, that's cool. We'll use that one. And what I can do here is duplicate my text. And then what I'll say down here, let me adjust that. Move that to the top and say something like, thanks for watching. You know, or you can say something like, check out my website or whatever you want. So you can put that down here. Thanks for watching. Or, you know, add it right here. Now it's kind of hard to see, but let's go ahead and add a shape to that. We'll go to shapes. Let's make it a little bit larger, and we'll change the color to, let's go with white. And now my font, we'll make my font. Let's make the font black. There we go. Thanks for watching. We'll put that down here. And I've got my end screen stuff there. Let's go ahead and move this a little bit this way. Oops. Let's grab the subscribe. So you can see, you can get creative in how your end screens can look like. Right now, I just showed you two different ones, one with your picture and one with the videos to watch and subscribe. So I'll have links in the description to different templates that you can check out and just remake and use as your own. And now you know how to create YouTube end screens with Adobe Spark. If you have any comments or questions, or you want to share your own end screen with me, please do drop it in the comment section. Don't forget to like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with others. Thank you for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.